Dear friends, welcome to InQuest, in-depth analysis and to the point. In this video, let us discuss about 5th October 2021 daily current affairs. This activity is useful for your UPSC, KPSC and all other competitive examinations. Dear friends, the index of today's discussion, number one, changes to Forest Act mooted. So in this article, we will be discussing about the changes that are actually in discussion with respect to Forest Act. Number two, US duo win Nobel for unlocking sense of touch and heat. So in this article, we will be learning about those two people who actually, you know, awarded Nobel for unlocking sense of touch and heat. Number three, new biodegradable polymer fabricated using gargum and chitosan has high potential for packaging material. So in this article, we will be discussing about properties of these two polymers. At the same time, this could be a great replacement to the plastic. Number three, first consignment of GI tagged sweet dish Mihidana from West Bengal exported to Bahrain. Number five, fifth edition of Japan and India bilateral maritime exercise that has been titled as JIMEX. So let's come to the first article, changes to Forest Act mooted. Now, what is this? To tell you in brief, let us say there is any infrastructure development with respect to border issue. So we are developing some infrastructure. Let's say we are developing integrated border management system. And the area that is designated to, you know, develop this infrastructure is the forest area. In that case, in order to use the land of forest area, the, you know, the clearance from the center is actually required. But according to this amendment that is in discussion, there won't be such clearance from the, you know, center is required to develop infrastructure with which is in relation to border issues and similar components that we will be discussing in that in this article. But earlier, there used to be forest clearance that was mandatory from the center for any such infrastructure developmental activities. Now, let's see the complete article. The Union government has proposed absolving agencies involved in national security projects. So this is what you need to note down. So in case of national security projects, number one, and border infrastructure projects, number two. So this is what is the example I gave you. So from obtaining prior forest clearance from the center as a part of amendments to the existing Forest Conservation Act, FCA. So henceforth, so if this is accepted, then there won't be any clearance needed for these two activities from the center. One is national security projects and the other one is border infrastructure projects. The FCA, that is Forest Conservation Act, which first came in the year 1980. So it came into existence in the year 1980 and was amended in 1988. Requires such permission. So the amendment that was done in the year 1988 for any such infrastructure developmental activities, clearance from the center was needed. The proposed amendment is part of larger rationalizing of the existing forest laws. Now, there is also a plan to exempt land acquired before 1980. So that is not all. Apart from that, if any land is acquired before commencement of this act, that is before 1980, the Forest Conservation Act, that is before the commencement of Forest Conservation Act or before this act came into effect by public sector bodies such as railways. So there won't be any, you know, requirement or clearance required by the center if the land is acquired before 1980 for the same purpose. As of today, a land holding agency, railway, NHAI and PWD, in case of railway infrastructure, development or highways or, with respect to public work departments, is required to take approval under the Act and pay stipulated compensatory levies such as net profit value and compensatory afforestation, etc. for use of such land which was originally been acquired for non-forest purposes. So these are all actually non-forest purposes. And if that land was, you know, initially taken, you know, if you take that land for any other purpose rather than, you know, non-forest purpose, then, for example, compensatory afforestation was compulsory. Now, what is compensatory afforestation? To tell you an example, so if you acquire a piece of land for any infrastructure development, then, you know, somewhere in the vicinity of the same, you know, area, you are supposed to, you know, supposed to bring in forest or grow plants or trees to, you know, compensate the loss by cutting the trees and etc. So this was necessary before, but now, you know, according to this amendment, there won't be such necessity for these, you know, purposes only, not for every other reason, only for these purposes, as I mentioned in the article. So number two, US duo win Nobel for unlocking sense of touch and heat. So US scientists, you need to remember the name, David Julius and Artem Patapotia won the Nobel Medicine Prize for discoveries on receptors for temperature and touch. So this you know, Nobel Award is given for the field of medicine. They've you know, rewarded for the field of medicine, and the duo research conducted independently. So actually they did not work together. They worked independently of each other in the late 1990s and 2000s. Is being used to develop treatment for wide ranges of diseases and conditions, including chronic pain. So they actually, you know, discovered receptors for temperature and touch that could be used to treat various diseases and, you know, conditions, including chronic pain. Let's go to article number three, Ministry of Science and Technology. So new biodegradable polymer fabricated using gar gum and chitosan has high potential for packaging material. So our team of Indian scientists have developed an environmentally friendly, it is non-toxic biodegradable polymer using these two. One is gar gum, other one is chitosan, both of which are polysaccharides. Polysaccharides is nothing but it is a carbohydrate which will have more monosaccharides in it, and extracted from gar beans and shells of crab and shrimps. The fabricated gar gum and chitosan film having high water stability. So this is the important property that we need to remember here, because this high water stability will be your, you know, the great or the best replacement to the plastic, high mechanical strength and excellent resistance to harsh environmental conditions can potentially be used in packaging applications. Polysaccharide is one of the biopolymer which with high potential for use in synthesis of packaging materials. Usually polysaccharides are very, you know, high potential, you know, because they can be used in packaging materials, but there was a drawback. Now, what is the drawback? Drawback of polysaccharides is they have such low mechanical properties, high water solubility. They are actually soluble in water. So whenever any component is soluble in water, that cannot be used for packaging materials, and low barrier properties, and they are not preferred. But now, in order to overcome these challenges of polysaccharides, Inspire Junior Research Fellow fabricated a gar gum chitosan composite film, which is a cross-linked polysaccharide without using any plasticizer. So plasticizers are any substances that are used to make substance soft with the help of a method called the solution casting method, a simple technique to make polymer film. So the technique that they used here is called as solution casting method. So now the fabricated biopolymer that is obtained here, you know, that had high water stability. So this was highly stable, or in simple words, I can say it is water resistant. It has high mechanical strength and excellent resistance to harsh environmental conditions. And because of all these properties, this could be the best replacement for plastic, because this is biodegradable, unlike plastic, which is not biodegradable. So with this, let's go to news number four. So this news number four is related to Ministry of Commerce and Industry. So first consignment of GI tagged sweet dish Mihidana from West Bengal exported to Bahrain. So you need to remember the sweet Mihidana belongs to the state of West Bengal and that has GI tag. So let's see the complete details here. In an effort to promote indigenous and geographical identification tagged products, first consignment of GI tag sweet dish Mihidana sourced from Bardhaman, West Bengal has been exported to Kingdom of Bahrain. The consignment of unique sweet dish Mihidana was exported to Bahrain by APEDA, that is Agricultural and Processed Food Product Export Development Authority, registered DM Enterprises, Kolkata, and imported by Al Jazeera Group, Bahrain. Let's see what you mean by GI tag. A GI tag is a sign denoted a specific geographical origin and possess qualities or reputation that are due to that origin. So that means the quality of any substance. Now, why they are important or why they have significant qualities which are distinct from the other similar products. The main reason is the geographical location. So due to its geographical location, they have the unique properties. So that is the reason why it is called as GI tag, that is geographical identification. GI, a form of intellectual property right. So this is actually a form of intellectual property right, and it is distinct from other forms of IPR in the sense it is not as same as other intellectual property right, as it ascribes the exclusivity to the community in a definite geography. So this is what I told you. So it has IPR related to geography, the place where it is produced or grown or anything. So rather than to an individual, as it is seen in case of trademark or patents. A GI tag can be issued for agricultural, natural, and manufactured goods that have unique quality, reputation, or other characteristics attributed to its geographical origin. So to name a few, for example, Darjeeling tea. There are many teas, but Darjeeling tea has GI tag because it has its own unique properties. So that has come because of its origin or the place. Then we have Basmati rice, Kanchipuram silk, Mysore silk, Hyderabadi Haleem, then Nagaland chili powder, etc., sold with GI tag and they have premium pricing. Now, let's know more about APEDA. So this has been carrying out promotional activities to bring unique and GI certified products to the agricultural and processed food products export map of India. APEDA provides assistance to set up pack houses across states which would fulfill the mandatory requirement or infrastructure for export of fresh fruits and vegetables to the international market. So this is the main activity or function of APEDA. So with this, let's go to article number 5. So this is related to Ministry of Defense. The 5th edition of Japan-India bilateral maritime exercise that is titled as JIMEX. A 5th edition of India-Japan Maritime Bilateral Exercise JIMEX between Indian Navy and Japan Maritime Self-Defense Force JMSDF will be held in Arabian Sea from 6th to 8th October 2021. So JIMEX, it is a series of exercises. This actually commenced in the year January 2012. So with special focus on maritime security cooperation. The last edition of JIMEX was conducted in September 2020. And now who will be participating from India in this 2021 JIMEX? So it is indigenously built guided missile stealth destroyer Kochi and guided missile frigate Teg under the command of Rear Admiral Ajay Kochar, Flag Officer Commanding Western Fleet, will represent the Indian Navy. Now, who will be representing Japan? The Japan Maritime Self-Defense Force will be represented by JMSDF, that is Japan Maritime Self-Defense Force, ships Kaga an Izumo-class helicopter carrier, and Murasame, a guided missile destroyer. In addition to ships, P-81 long-range maritime patrol aircraft, Dornier maritime patrol aircraft, then Integral helicopters and MiG-29K fighter aircraft will also participate in the exercise. GMX-21, now what is the aim of this exercise? Aims to develop common understanding of operational procedures and enhance interoperability through conduct of a multitude of advanced exercises across the entire spectrum of maritime operations. Multi-faceted tactical exercises involving weapon firing, cross-deck helicopter operations, and complex surface, anti-submarine, and air warfare drills will consolidate coordination and developed by the two navies. So these are the articles of the day. So if you have any questions, you can definitely put in comments box. We will try to reply to your questions. Thanks for watching. Namaskara.